Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Sports Factory Podcast. Man, this is special because this is the very first podcast of the 2023 NFL season. And everyone, they got input for their week one. I got my input. Jared got his input. Right. You know, John, he'll come on here. He got his input. But boy, you know whose input we got to start with, boy, because the whole summer we were talking about this man. We had Hard Knocks. We had
I need apologies, nigga.
No, but look. Maurice, you know, all the Jets fans that were cooking you and calling you a clown, saying that you stupid, you're an idiot, all these things, all these Jets fans. But you, the thing is, you knew.
Doubting your dreams, too. They trying to doubt your dreams.
Yeah, I forgot about that one. They said, man, I need to end this podcast. But the thing is, they don't know about plot. You feel me?
They don't.
Oh, John coming on. What's up, bro?
Here he comes.
Bro, look. I had to talk to Maurice real quick because, you know, Maurice obviously is very important to talk to Maurice today.
I'm talking off the edge.
So, Maurice, I want you to talk your ish because all those Jets fans, all them Jets fans who were cooking you this summer, you tell them that one win, me and you having that one win expectation, that was valid because you got no plot. So go ahead.
It's one of our best wins ever. Huh?
No, so hey, imagine you win that one game. Imagine you win that game and lose 16 straight games. You would have hit your expectations.
I did, and I'm happy. I'm happy for it.
Maurice, how you feel about Aaron Rodgers tearing his Achilles tendon in the first 2-3 snaps he has as a New York Jet?
Pretty. You know, it makes sense. I guess it's it makes sense.
Did it sink in?
I blame.
Who you blame?
Has it sunk in?
Yeah, has it sunk in? Has that sunk in?
That, like, I suck? Like, it's just, this is the end?
Yeah, I mean, you say just end the season. That's your name, so I assume it's sunk in.
But no, I would have put that regardless, you know.
Even if Aaron Rodgers won the game, he played the whole game and he won?
Yeah, it's Jets.
So,
it would have happened eventually.
Are you confident for the rest of the season? Like, what are you thinking? Are you trying to, like, tank it up? Are you trying to, you know,
trying to win the Super Bowl with Zach Wilson.
Okay. Do you believe in Zach Wilson?
Oh, bro, it's without a doubt in my mind, I know that he going to take me so far, bro.
Do you think that Zach Wilson needs any type of competition? Do you need any trades or anything, any pickups?
Comp? You think he needs comp? Aaron Rodgers barely beat him out. Just barely.
But I ain't hear that report, I ain't hear that report.
You didn't hear that shit? Zach Wilson was that nail, though.
I ain't hear that report.
Been that nigga.
He said he gonna give, if anybody give him competition, he giving them hell. That's what he did say.
And he gave him hell.
Because right, he tore his Achilles. He tore his Achilles immediately.
Right to them Achilles.
Maurice, are you feeling like, because obviously it's artificial turf. And I'm curious what y'all think as well.
No, I don't care about it. Stay
with me. Because artificial turf is the reason why his Achilles got torn, most likely. Most people, if you remember last year, Sterling Shepard, it looked like someone shot him in his knee because he was just running and then he started jumping up and he like holding his knee because of the artificial turf. And instead of having artificial turf, yes, crazy, right? You should have natural grass. And getting natural grass is significantly better usually than artificial turf, but artificial turf is cheaper.
Like, do you think more expensive, dog?
Do you think like this Aaron Rodgers injury is gonna like push?
No.
Do anything for y'all, like in terms of getting natural grass at least, because obviously it just usually happens at MetLife. Usually all this hell happens at MetLife Stadium too.
It's true. MetLife just be fucking people up, and it's always my team too, or like the New York teams. I mean, the New York teams. I meant to say.
And they play there the most, so you would think they would like change the natural grass. You don't think that'd be something?
They don't give a fuck about that shit. Cheapness. Hey, live in New York. It's expensive.
You know, I just realized I'm stupid. Just end the season is Jets, huh? That's the acronym. That's beautiful, boy. I don't know why you told me that too. And I was like, I know you told me that, but I just looked at that and I was like, boy, you know, y'all cook with creative like sadness, boy. Y'all like depressed rappers. That's what y'all do. That's what I like.
That is.
So
who's a depressed rapper? Never mind. It's like X. It's pretty ass out here, dog. It's pretty ass out here, dog. What was some shit? I felt some type of way when I'm pretty sure a lot of people felt some type of way. The Garrett Wilson thing when he said sorry, kid. I was like, damn, that's just sort of tough. Now he got this nigga. Now he got the MILF. It's just sort of tough, you know.
Is this
now he
is
got
this,
the MILF hunter throwing him the ball?
And that's tough. That hurt my fans team like crazy, boy. I tell you, that man value dropped. Garrett Wilson's value has dropped like hell in fantasy, boy. Garrett Wilson's about to be, he's going to start for me every week he's going to play. Now I got to do spot starts. Like, I may be here, maybe I'll start you, but I ain't starting him this week. I ain't starting him versus Dallas. Zach Wilson versus Dallas looks very stupid. I don't, because Zach Wilson can't do anything against moderate defense. I don't know what Zach Wilson's going to do against some defense like that. So, hey, now Garrett Wilson sitting on my bench. Good
against the Bills.
Who looked pretty good against
what?
The
guy who came in and won the game.
Who was that? The defensive team? The defense?
The defense
scored
that last touchdown?
Yeah, not Zach Wilson. Who scored that? The Xavier Gibson scored that touchdown.
He threw the touchdown. They tied the game, right?
That was a bad pass, Garrett. Thank you, Garrett Wilson, though. But thank you, Garrett Wilson, for catching it, though. The three interceptions and Josh Allen playing like he was concussed, because I don't know what. I bet John, we'll also get into, because, you know, I know you got some contentment and some hatred for Josh Allen. We'll get into that as well, because that's
hilarious. I don't understand. Are you going? You go on Instagram and they show like Zach Wilson had a better QBR than Patrick Mahomes, Josh Allen, and some one other nigga who lost. That's another thing. Joe Burrow.
I mean, yeah, he came in there, he played like a backup, then, like, did what he needed to do. Came in there, balled out, won the game.
He said balled out. I love it.
I intercepted. He threw that. That was a terrible interception he threw.
Oh, he did throw it. Zach was doing an interception, didn't he?
Of course
he was right to that man's hand.
Come on, bro. He jittered. You gotta expect. He always no jittered. Time. Like, he probably didn't have any.
He was jittered last year.
Is Aaron Rodgers. He said what?
He jittered last year.
This that is man jittered year, for right? his life. Yeah, it's 3rd year.
He always jittered.
All right, bro. Gotta give him some time, bro. Really, QBs don't just come in like the great ones come in and just be ready. But a lot of the times, like the moderate QBs, they're not just going to come in and start balling. I mean, look at Josh Allen. What QB just really comes in and just like dominate? They need to sit for a while. In this game, you can't really compare. It's not really fair. Because he didn't expect to play. Like, nobody expects him to play. Like, it's all of a sudden, like, okay, now you're in. Go win the game. That's really not fair for him.
I can kill him. It's just not him. He's just not that nigga, bro.
You said what?
He's just not that nigga, bro. He's just not.
That man.
That's not enough time to. I don't know, bro. It's the Jets. Like, you have to exactly. factor that in.
Exactly. There you go. That's the reason why he's just not that nigga.
That's tough, boy. That man, Maurice, no more. Because, look, we ain't listening to Maurice. We were bullying Maurice this whole summer. If Maurice know his plot the most. If everybody going to know their plot is a person that root for that team. And, boy, he know his plot was in the trash can. That is some of the – that is literally the most devastating injury in, like, recent NFL history. I have never seen – something get hyped up so much and drop so down, and it's that quick. The man had 3 snaps and had the literal worst injury probable.
And the first snap was like he was running for his life, but he threw the ball away, right?
Yeah,
he threw the ball away, and the second snap was a running play, maybe.
And yeah, I think, and the third snap, and the funny third snap,
it was my season ending.
We talked about Dwayne Brown. I was like, dang, you had Dwayne Brown? And I love how Dwayne Brown, the one that did not block.
It was that exact play, too.
He did not block that, man. We talked about, you have Dwayne Brown because he used to be a Texan. I thought he was still good, but obviously he watched that man. The way that man came on that man, Aaron Rodgers, and you see the Achilles pop. Boy, but Maurice, you called it, though. Because you were like, he knew it was Achilles. Maurice know his doom. You feel me? He know your doom. I was hoping
I knew it was Achilles.
I hope it was like an ankle, like maybe sprain, bad ankle sprain, maybe broken. You get like 6 weeks. That man knows. Maurice said, no, it's done. No, he out for the season, and that's it.
It's Achilles.
You think Aaron Rodgers should retire after this, though? Because this is, 39 years old.
Should retire?
Hard. You think he should retire?
No, he's not going to retire. Or should he, or will he?
They say should he, because he said he's not going to retire. But you think he should?
I don't think so. I feel like I don't know if he owed the team. That's the wrong word to say. Not owe. I think that's sort of fucked up to say, because he don't really owe anybody anything. But it's more like,
man,
the morale, not the
contract, so he definitely owe y'all something.
I guess he do, but in terms of like, I feel like it would be a bad look. Like I feel like he's not that type of guy to just abandon his team or abandon like, because you know they're Warriors, like they go on the field, because you know football players they like to compare themselves to fucking Warriors and shit, and you can't just abandon your niggas like that. So I'm sure he'll come back. I think he should come back. Now, will he be the same Aaron Rodgers?
No, he gonna be Buns.
Well, we have to wait and see about that.
He's not gonna be good. You know that. Like a big part of him is his running and moving around. He's 40 years old, and they not changing that grass. They keep our official turf. Why that gonna happen next year? Probably just happen sometime next year.
Next time he gonna pop his vertebrae and shit.
he gonna be his next Achilles. So, no, they said there's a 40 year old quarterback. He playing in the like rainy type weather on artificial turf. I mean, yeah, it's a matter of time, and y'all ain't gonna change it. And if, like I said, this wasn't the thing, go ahead.
No, if they want to keep artificial turf, they need to get like a dome or some shit.
Anyway. Yeah, because like if this is the thing that doesn't change your grass, then yeah, you're just gonna keep getting that. You have no plots.
Damn, and my knee started hurting when I thought about that shit too. I don't know why.
I think honestly, what just happened for you is the worst form of. It's like that's the biggest form of bad plot I've seen in like 10 years. I think go ahead.
What was the last time you said this is the biggest, the most devastating injury? What was the last time then?
I'm trying to think. What is a more devastating injury in history of this league? Like I said, recent, because I don't want to think. Maybe in the 90s, someone got hurt. But like I'm thinking, like maybe no, there's no one. It's maybe in basketball, but like there's no one in football. Like who? Do y'all know of a person who got injured at such an inopportunistic time that it literally like cost everything? I can't think of that. Did someone tear the AC on like a Super Bowl, or did someone like I can't think of anything.
Nah, Andrew Luck is not as good. It's not as bad as this one.
Nah, it's not. It's not.
There's Tom Brady when he tore his ACL. It's not as bad as this
it's,
one.
It's not because like they had the like. They had, you know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't that. It was bad, but like, okay, next year, we're fine. And they won 11 games. But y'all, like, I don't know. He didn't have a completion.
What about when he broke his neck, Peyton Manning?
I mean, that was perfect for the Colts. I mean, that was the best time because they had a generational quarterback coming out in the draft that exact year. Now, sure, technically, that could be you too. Caleb Williams is coming out, but you're not the Colts. You understand that, right? You ain't got Colts plot. You got Jets.
It's not that I don't think we're gonna get the first overall pick. It's more like I feel like we're just not gonna draft Caleb Williams.
I actually think
we'll trade it. Probably trade that shit.
Why would you do that though? If you had the first pick, you wouldn't draft Caleb Williams?
No, I would.
No, but you don't think they would?
Yeah.
Why would they do that? That's the dumbest decision in history.
Right, we make a lot of dumb decisions.
No, but you can't have no old man with an Achilles tear and Zach Wilson, and he got Caleb Williams, and you pick.
They got.
But y'all not even gonna be close to the number one pick.
Because they good, right?
Win like 7 games.
They studs, boy.
Damn.
For real, how? Wait, you think they gonna win 7 games?
Yeah.
Because we won 7 games last year.
Yeah, there you go.
Is that why?
I mean, look who y'all got on y'all team. I don't know how old Adrian Peterson's son is, but obviously it's Breece Hall. Like, he has 16 fantasy points.
I was confused.
I don't know how he got that. Bro, he averaged like 12 yards a kick. I'm like, bro, what is going on? Like, he looked pretty good. He looked pretty solid. I'm going to be very upset if he don't do this again. Like, throughout the year, if this is just the one game he decides to go crazy,
never feel that fancy.
I can definitely see him doing that. But yeah, I mean, great defense travel, you know, just like the Broncos.
Bro, Aaron Rodgers being on that team, like, bro, y'all be in the AFC Championship or something.
You know,
it'll just be meaningless.
It'll make a big difference, but I say y'all still get, and then y'all looking at other QBs, bro. Like y'all may. Well, if I were y'all, I would bring in Carson Wentz.
I'd bring in Jacoby Brissett.
I would bring in Brissett. There's one person I did think about, but this will never happen because I think this will kill Zach Wilson's confidence. I was thinking about bringing back Sam Darnold.
That's ironic. You come back to me. It all comes back to me.
What?
Because the only reason I would say that is because he's been playing. But the reason why I know they're not going to do it, obviously, but they shouldn't do it. Because I forgot that we change offenses. We're not in the West Coast San Francisco offense anymore. We're in Nathan Hackett's offense.
But
because he's played well with the 49ers. That's the reason why.
Jacoby, he's like
you need a game manager. I need
Carson Wentz, like his low is super low, but his high can be pretty high.
I don't know. That sounds like Zach Wilson.
I think he want a mid.
I need somebody.
He hasn't reached the high yet, though. He hasn't reached the high. We've seen what Carson Wentz have reached.
I just need somebody.
I think he want mid.
You won't need much out of him.
I need mid.
Need mediocre.
You won't need him to go win you. Like, you won't need him to.
But you also need somebody to lose you.
Magnificent.
And Jacoby Brissett not going to do that. I don't think Jacoby
would say. I mean, Carson will. I think Carson
through the year, but when it comes playoff time, like I don't see him having the capabilities of, like, you know.
We'll see.
But I don't think if you get
to the next level,
if you get a guy like that, you're not really looking to even try to get him to the next level. I think you're just trying to get to the playoffs, and then if you do get to the playoffs, then just have experience. Let the defense carry type of thing.
But Carson Wentz, I know, like, his last couple years haven't been the greatest.
They've been tough.
Carson Wentz seems like a boomer.
That defense, Carson Wentz, running back. That type Carson of head coach, like a boomer bust. Like, you put it all together, I think Carson Wentz, you know.
I think
see
it's
what,
like,
he can do against us personally with scrubs. So you give him somebody like Breece Hall,
Wilson, Gary Wilson.
Yeah, Wilson and all of that. Lazard seems like a pretty good leader from a clip I saw. So you give him all those guys, I feel like he's not going to be with Aaron Rodgers. He's going to take y'all, but, you know. Y'all can at least compete in the East.
I think it's like stocks. I think it's like you have a more risky. Yours, like, we trying to get bonds and you trying to get the stock. Because we trying to stay steady. But you, like, because Carson Wentz can do more, like, in moments. If he's playing really well, he's, you know, better. But then there'll be games he'll throw three interceptions and, like, be losing his mind. Exactly. And you're just kind of like, so it's like.
Like Josh Allen.
Josh Allen, I was about to say the same exact thing.
I think his low is Brissett,
so
even
low,
at his low,
Brissett.
I think he's still better.
His low is Zach Wilson. His low is pretty tough.
I don't think his low will be what it was. Like, he was in Washington. He went, I mean, I guess with the Colts, that was pretty bad against the Jaguars, but I don't know. He had a decent season with the Colts. I mean, it came down to one game. I think I can't really remember the game that much, but seemed like it was some coaching mistakes that could have, you know, changed the dynamic of that game. But for the most part, like, you know, like, we don't need that much out of you. When he was in Washington, their defense was not good that year he played with them. So it's like, we have a good defense. We don't need you to go be Josh Allen, Patrick Mahomes. We don't need you to be these guys. We need you to be great only when it's time to be great. Like, so, for the most part, you know, he can be a game manager. And then every once in a while, you're going to need him to step up and go get that touchdown. But for the most part, he, you know, I think he can coast by
for Geno Smith
to where it won't be that much pressure on him. I think pressure is like what be folding him.
So if they get Carson Wentz, how many wins do you think the Jets can get? And how far can they go?
I really have to see their schedule again, but I mean, I can see about 9 or 10. It's really like, I mean, because you either need a good defense or good offense, bro. Like, their defense will, you see, well, I don't know if it was just Josh Allen or if it was their defense is that good. Like, I don't know which one it was. But if you're going to have a defense that's going to get you 4 turnovers, I mean, he's at least better than Zach Wilson. So, you know, add him to the mix. Like, for instance, the Bills definitely could have won that game by just, if you put a different QB back there, they would have won that game.
Most definitely.
You muted.
Yeah, I can't hear you.
Oh, he's talking about him.
I don't know how much of a difference Carson Wentz can make.
I don't think so, yeah.
Maybe one more win than Zach Wilson, but I don't think it's going to be that significant of a jump.
It just seemed like another boom or bust. Like, his boom, of course, will be, like, amazing, but I think he's more likely to be a bust. Anything, I'd rather just go for somebody like, I don't know if I'm sure that Jacoby Brissett is gonna be like that nigga, but at least I'm more confident that Carson Wentz could lose me a game than Jacoby Brissett can lose me a game.
Yeah, I think Jacoby Brissett is safer.
I think that's what it comes down to. If I was to have Carson Wentz, I might just keep Zach Wilson. Like, but if I'm just to get one extra win, I might as well just keep Zach Wilson at that point.
I wouldn't say you'll get one extra win though. I'll say with Carson Wentz, like, for instance, like the Jets' aspiration this year, I don't know about you, but for overall normal Jets fan, their aspiration is to win a Super Bowl. So with Jacoby, that's not going to happen. And I'm not saying it's going to happen with Carson Wentz, but I feel like it takes you, like, you'll be closer with him than you would be.
So you wouldn't go all in at this point?
Well, I mean, because it's, for y'all, it's boom and bust. Like, y'all had all, y'all pushed all your chips. If this was poker, you pushed all your chips in the middle of the table. So I want to get somebody that's going to, like, that has the best shot that's available, of course. I don't, I feel like Jacoby, like, he'll keep you afloat. Like, he'll keep you, you know, you'll win, like, games with him. But when it's time,
I feel like, in the playoffs, because we're supposed to rely on our defense, right? Like, I'm assuming you want us to rely on our defense.
Right. But Carson Wentz can be a game manager. That's possible for him, too. It's also, like, what team are you playing on? Who's your head coach? So, that those, like, with Cooper Rush, that's all we needed. It was, like, somebody to coast and get us through.
Cooper Rush,
like,
another one, too.
A lot of games that Dak lost, Cooper Rush would have won. But come playoff time,
he's a winner.
Right. But come playoff time, Cooper Rush is going to cap out. Just like when we played the Eagles, he capped out. You need somebody that, like, can take you in. I mean, Dak didn't get it done either, but I like our chances better with Dak than Cooper Rush. Jacoby is like a Cooper Rush.
Cooper Rush could be another person. No, I still can't hear you, just so you know. Hey, you
said Cooper Rush is what?
Cooper Rush is cool. I wouldn't mind Cooper Rush. But
I think he's better
than
Carson Wentz.
That's true. And that, I also think that they're just not going to trade. they're not going to get. I think they're going to probably stick with Zach Wilson. A part of me feels like that as well.
Yeah.
Because do they have to trade, though?
No, there's no for Cooper Rush. Agent,
right?
I have no idea. Oh no, Carson Wentz is definitely.
Carson Wentz is,
He's
like, I don't know about Cooper Rush.
Oh no, y'all ain't getting Cooper Rush. That's crazy.
Oh,
that's crazy.
No, exactly. That's what I'm saying. And plus, also, if we wasn't getting Cooper Rush, like if I was the Cowboys and I knew that you guys desperately need a quarterback, I would try to upsell y'all as much as possible, or upsell me as well. For sure. So like. Cooper Rush, like, in actuality, maybe he's worth, like, a fifth-round pick, fourth-round pick, or something like that. I'm going to try to get, like, a third or second-round pick out of you for that reason.
His sample size, you know, his career wins and loss look pretty good, so.
Yeah, I still don't think that's worth it.
Well, I guess our leverage go down a little bit because we got Trey Lance, so.
It is frustrating, man. It was a really boring game. I don't know if any of you watched it. It was, they were the exact same team. The both
really?
Bad teams.
No way.
Like similar passing stats, similar rushing stats, similar penalties. It was gross. Broncos.
Wait,
had,
you mean the game? Or what, do you mean like the game was
Broncos,
the exact
Broncos
same
Raiders,
stat? Oh, I thought you meant like the team. Like
they looked exactly the same.
Damn, that's
and
ass.
It was disgusting. No explosive plays, a lot of dink and dunk. Russ looked better. And he played better, but the result was the same. I think Russ did exactly what Sean Payton wanted him to do. And it was just, it was bad. We had, Caden Stearns went out. So it was Damari Mathis was getting cooked all game by anybody. Pat Surtain did pretty well against Davante Adams. But yeah, whoever their second string, it was Jacoby Myers. Jacoby Myers was cooking Damari Mathis all game, and it was bad. Broncos only had 6 drives the whole game. I think Raiders had 5 or 6 as well. It was just a weird game. Broncos scored on 3 of their 6 drives. Missed 1 field goal was the 4th drive. 30-yard punt. We went 30 yards and then punted, and then a 3-and-out at the end of the game. Like, it wasn't bad. I think having 4 potential scoring drives out of 6 is good and can normally win you games. We missed a field goal and an extra point, which put us behind. I didn't like Sean Payton's start of game onside kick. it felt unnecessary. Against the Chiefs, maybe the Chargers, because they're a lot better. So stealing a possession against those teams, you might need that. But I felt we could have beat the Raiders without that.
Did that come back and hold you?
I mean, they scored on that drive because they got it at like our 40 or something like that because of the penalty.
That game started off pretty fire, though. Like, if I remember correctly, y'all like went down and scored, right? I was watching a little bit. But like y'all scored pretty fast. Like, did the Raiders score a touchdown or a field goal?
Touchdown.
Okay, yeah. So
they scored first, then we came back and scored.
Yeah, it looked like it was gonna be. It looked promising. Just after that, you know, it became a defensive game, which is surprising because Raiders aren't known for defense.
This is random. Oh, have you started yet?
Be random. Go ahead. It could be random. Say what you're gonna say.
It says on a top tier Bills reporter was talking trash about Stephon Diggs, but he didn't realize his mic was on. It says there's no control over Stephon Diggs. Dude is going to do whatever he wants to do. He'll look in my face and say, fuck you, and that's how he treats everybody.
That's funny, boy. Mm-hmm. But he looked more prominent when he was talking to Josh Allen. He looked more like, because I usually yell at Josh Allen. But he looked good in this game. He was like, you know, trying to get him, encourage him and all. But maybe Josh Allen needs to get yelled at because he was playing so terrible. I don't know. Jared, quick talk to Broncos. Just quick thought about the Broncos. Are y'all gonna have a better season than last year?
Yes.
Is Sean Payton overrated?
Maybe a little bit. It depends where you rate him. People rate him differently.
Where do you rate him?
Above Nathaniel Hackett.
I mean, that's simple enough. Right? from 1 to 10, how good of a coach is Sean Payton?
7.
Does anyone think he's higher or lower than 7?
Some people do, yeah.
Oh, I think he's asking us.
I'm asking you. I'm definitely asking you. Mauricio, John, do you think he's higher or lower than a 7?
Higher or lower than a 7?
Out of 10 as a coach. A good 70%, though, a good C.
I'm supposed to know just based on one game.
According to him, he saw no improvement in them games boring like last year, that's tough. Because I thought he was going to come here and spark it up.
Have Jerry Jeudy. I don't think Jerry Jeudy was there.
No, he's out for a few weeks.
So, yeah.
Who cost you this?
You got number one wide receiver.
But who cost you the game? Was it like, was the coaching, Russell, defense? Who cost you this game?
Will Lutz, probably.
That's who Maurice picked up to. That's Maurice's fantasy kicker. That's tough.
Will Lutz. For the Saints, technically. But, hey, you know.
He should be better in Denver. He got altitude.
That's what I thought so, too.
He should be, but he wasn't.
So you're saying your plot, all of our plots are terrible, as you know. You already know all of our plots are terrible. And, you know, hey, maybe you keep the same list from what we had a couple weeks ago when I said, I had the worst plot in the last 5 years than Maurice. But I don't know. Like I said, Maurice, your plot kind of is, I think it's higher because that Aaron Rodgers injury is probably the most craziest injury I've ever seen in my life. But, Jared, like, if you face the Chiefs, say you face the Chiefs, do you think this team can beat the Chiefs? Because that's the whole goal. You just win one game, you beat the Chiefs. Do you think that could be a thing?
Yeah, I think we can.
You can beat the Chiefs?
Yeah. It's not like we can beat the Chiefs. But it's, I think if things go right, we can beat the Chiefs.
I'll tell you, Jared, on my stream, there's a Chiefs fan. He was on there, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
I'm like,
Jay something. Yeah.
But I'm like, boy, Jared, you're missing stuff. But I need you on that stream. That is what I need. I need a man with some plot. You know what I'm saying? That man sitting with plot. And that's a beautiful thing. So definitely that you know, I just need an Eagle fan to just pop up and find my streams. And we just cooking. We definitely just cooking some in the pot. I do need to go and talk about the team, the Dallas Cowboys, and their beating of the New York Giants, which, you know, when I saw the game, I saw the play when Daniel Jones, and this is me just watching, I saw Daniel Jones throw the ball, Saquon, it got tipped up and intercepted. I said, I'm going to go watch some Naruto. Because obviously, you can see that game is just going to go into descent hell. I jinxed Maurice because, you know, John, your team was supposed to win in fantasy because, you know, the defense of the Cowboys had 46, which is like the second or third most that I've seen in this fantasy thing. But Maurice's team had like a balanced effort. He had Hill.
This nigga jinxed me because I called him during the game, right? And he was saying, like, at this point, because I actually thought I was going to lose. I still think I should have lost, but that's besides the point. Because I didn't think Maurice Hall would be like that. But I called him during the thing, and he was saying, like, oh, you know, Yeah, I didn't expect that. I didn't expect not Dak Prescott, Daniel Jones to be this awful or some shit. You kept jinxing my shit. Every single time you said, oh, no, nah, they'll score some points. The Niggas didn't score a single point or another turnover will happen. He'd be home with me, bro.
Nah, I mean, you won. I tell you, you won, though. Like, you, what's up? You won.
Still, you tore his Achilles, too.
So you won at what cost?
At what cost?
That man, the funny thing, Maurice, technically, you should have had a good, because you won in fantasy and you won in real life. And they were both thrilling wins, too. Mm-hmm. They're both like last second type things. Why where do you I came feel back. So awful, then? But he didn't feel like he came but he can't eat nothing in the long run. That's funny. John, how you feeling about the Dallas Cowboys? Obviously, the defense is the thing that really shut, you know, obviously did all the great things there. And Tony Pollard, because Tony Pollard, you play well. You can have a Saquon Barkley case, because Saquon Barkley didn't play well, but Tony Pollard did.
How you feeling about it? I wouldn't judge it like that, because, I mean, the defense he went against and the defense. Well, the Giants got a solid defense, but the way the game was going, it wasn't working for them. So I wouldn't judge it on that. It's like I need a whole season from each person to, like, really say that, like, okay, he's better than Saquon. But, I mean, Saquon did have that fumble, which is pretty funny. Like, soon as he but and that was Trayvon Diggs who caused it, which is even funnier because people say he's afraid to hit. But nah, for the most part, like, I don't judge this win. I need to see what we can do next week.
No, I mean, that should be the same defense. Thing same, I feel like okay.
You need to look at somebody else see better.
But we're going against, like, a competent defense.
I think you said the Giants defense is good.
It is, but it's like they're not a bit, like I told you, that's our little brother. Like, I need to go against a team so that we don't face twice a year. Like, the Giants, they have a good defense against, like, people outside of our division. Like, if they're going against the Vikings and they're going against teams like that, like, they can do stuff. But for the most part, it's hard to do stuff, like, when our defense is playing so well. Because you're getting the ball back. Now you have to pass the ball. Now we know what you want to do. You got Saquon. You can't run the ball because you down so much. Like, and our offense, like, we got the ball. Like, the first possession we got the ball, we end up kicking a field goal. So it's stuff like that. Like, we're not scoring in the red zone. Had our defense not scored so much, had our defense not put them in such good positions, who knows what would have happened. So that's kind of, like, how I judge it. But for the most part, you know, next week we'll see. I'm curious to see how our offense is going to play. That's what's more important to me.
If they struggle, say your offense struggles like hell, but you win the game like 13-0, something like that, 13-3. How you feeling?
I mean, I don't know how you want me to feel. I'm just taking it week by week. I'm not getting too high. I'm not getting too low. Just it's week by week, like. I'm waiting for the playoffs. We do something in the playoffs, then, you know.
You number one in the cool. I think you're number one in the power rankings. I feel like you're number one. Aren't you, like, number one or at least number two in the power rankings? I feel
it
like.
Should be San Francisco.
Do you think San Francisco's win is more impressive than your win?
It's definitely your win.
Yes, because of who we played. If it was any other team besides the Giants, then I could feel a little higher. But it's the Giants, like.
But that's I think it matters more is division rivals. Y'all play harder against. They couldn't see the fucking Steelers.
But we always blow them out, like it's the Steelers. Like the Steelers, like I don't know why y'all bet on Steelers to win.
I thought Kenny Pickett played so much better in the preseason. I didn't expect Kenny Pickett to that preseason play. He tricked me.
Let me trade for him.
I knew from the jump, like. They defense, and I don't know, the 49ers is just such a great team, so yeah, I'll say their win was more impressive just for the fact that it was against a more competent team.
I don't know.
Like, I think the Giants are better, but not when they're facing us. If that makes sense.
That's year, like, by year. I don't think the Giants are gonna be a playoff team.
If we switch teams, the Giants definitely make it a playoff. But we switched teams. Like,
they showed you something that gonna make.
If we did that to the Steelers and they did that like what they did to the Giants, then I'll say ours was more impressive. But the fact that we played the Giants is like, I can't feel high about that. If it's the Eagles, yeah, but the Giants, it's like Giants, Washington, like I can't get anything from that.
I feel like Washington got a better chance in my mind for some reason to make the playoffs than the Giants. I feel like the Giants, I don't know. Daniel Jones, like the, I don't know. It especially 40-0 is pretty tough. That's a confidence boost. Like, no, confidence hit. That hurts your confidence so much. And I know they're going to win some, like, they'll win some games, but I feel like they may make the playoffs, but they're not like a slamming. Like, oh, they definitely make playoffs. I don't think they like
it. No, they definitely make it.
He said that's a slam dunk, huh? Yeah,
it's a slam. Well, I'm willing to bet that, yeah.
So that means three NFC teams gonna make the playoffs.
NFC East team.
NFC East teams, I mean.
Yeah, I thought Washington was too, but the way they played against the Cardinals was a little I don't know. I gotta see how their season plays out. I think the Giants have bounced back, bro. Like overall, like their defense, you know, they got a lot of key players on there. They got Saquon. Daniel Jones is the weak link, but you can play around him, you know, like run the offense through the person who should have got paid. It's hard to do that when you know, going against a high powered offense and a defense that's scoring. But for the most part, they don't really have to.
Look, I actually think
our defense, the Eagles and the 49ers and everybody else should be, you know, should be anybody's game.
I think y'all still would have won, but the Giants could have scored. Like, I don't think they they could have scored. It was just,
yeah, we still would have won.
I think the game just started off wrong, and it just went all downhill from then. It started off terrible.
Had we not blocked that field goal, who knows what would have happened? Because that's really 3 points. Because that should have been 3 points. Because they were like super close.
Or the phone, like, thing would have popped up in the air.
Yeah. So.
Them boys did everything wrong, boy.
Well timed. So that was intentional.
Them boys did everything wrong. That's
I was really surprised Saquon didn't catch that. I know who's somebody who would have.
I know Pollard the guy. Boy, I tell you, Pollard.
I think you're going to say Trayvon Diggs, but okay, yeah, him too.
They both catch it. Trayvon Diggs could play receiver if he wanted. That's hilarious. Well, so you believe in the Giants, and it almost seems like you believe more in the Giants than the Cowboys. You say he definitely makes playoffs. That's hilarious.
Definitely making the playoffs too, bro.
But who going to win the division? You think the Eagles going to win the division?
No, we win in the division.
But what make you confident? Because, you know, funny thing, the Eagles,
like plot, don't you?
I mean, I do like plot, but I feel like the Eagles.
If you like plot, then we're winning it.
I think, but Eagles have better plot.
Our plot. I'm saying the NFC East plot.
Oh, you mean like every year someone different?
Yes.
So why not?
So just by going off of plot, we should win it.
Let me see. Has there been a back-to-back in
20 years, bro?
It's never been a back-to-back.
No, not in the last 20 years. Well, because the Eagles like 18, were running, but I'm around up.
The Eagles, that's hilarious.
In the last 20 years. I mean, the Eagles.
They were the last team to do it.
I ain't saying it's just going to be like an easy picking, but I feel like we got the tools. We got we got everything we need to, make it happen.
What new tools do you have this year compared to last year?
Oh, yeah, Takyo-ish. Yeah, Takyo-ish, yeah. He know.
Brandon Cooks.
That's
your tool.
You got Stephon Gilmore.
Stephon Gilmore, he played well, too.
Stephon Gilmore. I mean, Dak was hurt. That's another thing, too. Like, a lot of those games, like, for instance, we could have beat the Jaguars. What happened was, what's his name? I forgot his name. Noah Brown. The ball hit his hands, popped up in the air, pick six. Like, that's a game we would have won. So, it's stuff like that. Like, Mike McCarthy, he's more conservative than Kellen Moore. So it's stuff like that. A lot of the games, like, say, for instance, against the Jets. I mean, not the Jets. Against Green Bay. Like, we had such a big lead. Like, those type of games, we probably wouldn't lose with somebody calling different plays. Like, okay, let's run the ball. You know, Kellen Moore, he tried to get cute. And even in the red zone, which I think, like, even against the Giants this last game, we tried to do some little trick play, which I was like, what are y'all doing? Just, go forward. Like, why are you doing all this extra stuff? I think, and that's why we end up settling for a field goal. But I think our coaches will go look at the film and see, all right, let's not do that again. I mean, it's the Giants, so you really can, like, freestyle and do whatever we want. But going against a competent team, I don't think we would do something like that. So it's just stuff like that. So I think we got what it takes. I like our defense better.
I'll tell you what. So the three NFC teams, you know, the Eagles start off really well, but they usually start off well and they start to like stall out and then team come back, but they win.
That was but a horrible still, game for them, though. They should have lost. I can't believe it, bro. They ran a screen. The Patriots ran a screen on 3rd and 13, got 2 yards, and tried to complete it on 4th and 11. Like, that was so dumb, and it made me so mad. I'm like, bro, what are you doing?
Yeah, but his plot got to circulate because, you know, they ain't got Tom Brady no more. That plot not going that way.
They won. They did what they were supposed to do, I guess.
NFC teams?
Mac Jones is balling, bro. I had to pick him up in fantasy.
They need to trade for Mac Jones. That was stupid.
If he could get that many yards against the Eagles defense, I'm like, hold on now.
I'd say the highest rated rookie was the Eagle, and they D tackle Jalen Carter. It's like a mm-hmm. and he was killing it, boy. Say, the rich get richer with that. So, hey, the top three NFC teams did well, but hey, the top three AFC quarterbacks, they all lost. They all sitting at 0-1. They ain't at the top of their division right now. Now, it's kind of easy. Who had a worse performance? I'm not gonna say Patrick Mahomes, but Josh Allen. Josh Allen and Joe Burrow. Who had a worse performance? Josh Allen or Joe Burrow?
Because their performance is. I mean, Josh Allen. Josh Allen.
Yeah. I mean, Joe Burrow. Allen. Okay.
Oh, wait. What's his stats?
Joe Burrow had like 82 yards. Y'all saying that like so quick. Like, he had 82 yards. He got bent in that fourth quarter. He had no interceptions, but he ain't do nothing.
But it was a rainy game, right? What the Bills? But the thing about Josh Allen interceptions is, okay, the first one, people say it's a punt. Bro, it's 3rd and 8. Like,
yeah, that's
he could have ran for the first down, or even if he wouldn't have got it, it would be 1-on-1 in open field, like a DB, or maybe it was a linebacker. They're not tackling him. Or even if it's going to become like 4th and 1 or something like that, he was at least going to gain 7 yards. So why not just run for it? But he threw the ball. They want to say it's an arm punt. Okay, fine, whatever. The first one, all right, whatever. We'll give him that. Then the second one, it's like you do the same thing again. And then you do it again. Like, at that point, it's like, come on, bro. Like, your IQ is... You got to question his IQ, bro.
Do you think he overrated? Do you think he overrated?
Tell me. 3 interceptions. two back-to-back that was, like, just unnecessary. Like, if you think... He's the Westbrook of the NFL. So if you think Westbrook,
keep going.
But it's a reason he led in red zone interceptions. Like it's some up here, because if you just lead the league in interceptions, okay, you know, maybe just not good. But when you're leading interceptions in the red zone, it's a reason why that's happening. Like, and just look at the way he's not. And I don't want to say he's not smart, but he doesn't play smart. Just like when he tried to hurdle a guy, he's 5 yards from the first down. What are you reaching out to hurdle, like, over him? You're not a yard away. You're 5 yards away. Like, why are you doing stuff like that?
Horrible.
It's just stuff he doesn't play smart at all.
Do you think
he takes a lot of unnecessary contact, too?
Oh, he does take a lot of bad hits. He tried to be like Cam Newton. But Cam Newton's career is short for a reason. But do you think he's still top three?
I don't want to get, like, hey, from what he did to my fantasy, I definitely took him out of top three. Because, bro, 4 turnovers. Like, if he just didn't have 1 turnover, I would have won. I mean, if he would have just took away 1 of those turnovers. And that's what I'm saying. Like, 2 of them was just unnecessary. That's the problem. It's okay to turn the ball over. Everybody would say he's a gunslinger. Okay, the first one is fine. But you're going to do the same thing over and over and over. The fumble. Even the fumble was fine. Because it's like, okay, you mishandled the ball. That's fine. But it's like, come on, bro. Like, you can't keep doing the same thing over and over and costing your team a game. Like, they may have won, just him not, I don't know.
Yeah, I think that's why it feels worse than Joe Burrow. Because it feels like the Bills had that game.
Most definitely.
And Josh Allen gave it away.
Right.
And then Joe Burrow was just like, no one could do anything correctly. And it was just everyone going
down. Yeah, I mean, and it's the Browns, like. And that's what I'm saying. Like, the Bills got the Jets got a good defense, so it's like, it's understandable. But it's the way his interceptions came.
No, that's really the problem. Were definitely on it. The last one was a really good play. I mean, they're all good plays by Whitehead, Jordan Whitehead. But the two is just like overthrown ball, just throwing the double coverage. It shouldn't make no sense. You don't do shit like that.
And it's who he's throwing it to, bro. If you're gonna do that, throw it to at least Stephon Diggs. Or like
one of them was Stephon Diggs.
So John, would you rather have
that to Randy Moss or somebody, bro? Like, you're doing it to the wrong people.
So would you rather, John, would you rather have Josh Allen or Justin Herbert?
As my QB?
As your QB. Ooh.
I'm taking Josh Allen. Like, if you give him the right coach, like, I think that goes away. It's kind of like what we're talking about with Carson.
So you don't think Justin Herbert the same way?
No, I think Herbert's a top 5
quarterback.
Justin Herbert,
I think he played well. Did he play well? I think he played well. They ain't close.
He had the ball at the end of the game.
They didn't close.
Hey,
he can't close, but who, like, was he like James Harden or something? He can't close? Is that just
if
like.
If you put Justin Herbert in that game, place Justin Herbert with Josh Allen. If you replace Justin Herbert, if you replace Justin Herbert with Josh Allen, who wins that game?
Probably the Bills. Yeah, if you put Justin Herbert, they'll win that game. I mean, just like his IQ is good. It's just like, you know?
He can't close.
James Harden has a good IQ. It's just like. When it's time to execute, you're not executing. And this is regular season, so he would have been fine. But it's like when it's that time to execute, you know. Josh Allen, I don't know, bro. His IQ is in the bottom 5 or something.
In the league. Like,
yes.
Ooh.
Yes.
Well, you can't chalk it up to one bad game, though. You can't just say, let me just chalk it up to.
No. He has 84. Bro, he led the league in turnovers last year. That's not one bad game. I'm telling you, this is who he is. It's just, it was more amplified because it's, you know, a national game and it was 4 turnovers. But for the most part, like, he has 84 total turnovers. I know, and Dak has 90, so that's only like 60. You know what I'm saying?
But you do the math on that. You'd rather have a guy you think has a bottom 5 IQ versus another guy who just can't close?
Okay, well, let me put it like this. I think... with the right coach, you put him on the Patriots, he's not going to do what he's doing. That's what I'm saying. Like, even though his IQ is bottom 5, it can be changed. Like, there's stuff to eliminate. Like, don't make him think so much. Or just don't give him the green light on certain things. Like, say, for instance, a lot of coaches wouldn't accept him doing that. Or they're going to call plays where he's not going that deep. It's just certain stuff that you can do to eliminate it. Like, if your players is lacking, it's where you come in and be like, okay, let's do some things different. If I know my QB doesn't have like a strong arm to throw the ball deep, then maybe I won't call that many deep ball plays. You know what I'm saying? So there's things to do to change that. It's not like he's just dumb. It's just
you could also,
he uses his athleticism too much. He relies on it. And when it's not there for him, it's time for him to think. But now it's too late to think. You should be thinking before you use your athleticism. But he, just like Mahomes, Mahomes thinks and then use athleticism. Josh Allen, athleticism, then he thinks. Which is,
and that's why he got no plot. And that's why he's 0-5 in overtime. That man's 0-5 in overtime. That's tough.
So, yeah. But I think, you know, his talent is enough to where it pulls him up to top 5. It's just maybe now it's time for a coach. Now it's time for a QB coach to come in and just like wrap their arms around him. Like, it's going to be okay, bro.
They're talking about offensive coordinators. They're talking about changing. Like, the Bills fans are like, we need to change offensive coaching. So, hey, you know, there's some merit to that.
That's really the problem. I mean, if you have the skill set, now we need somebody who's going to unleash it. Just like, I mean, they had Giants head coach?
He said, "Kellen, Brian Daboll."
Yeah, they had him the year he played good. Is what people are saying.
That's what I'm saying.
Even last year, he made, you know, Daniel Jones.
But yeah, but decent. he came from the
so
Bills.
So give him a coach like that and just, you know, let him, you know, like we got Dan Quinn. Changed our
defense. I'll tell you,
Brian
statistically,
came from the Bills.
We had the worst defense that year. I think it was 2020. The next year we were in top 5. You know. So it's just like you need one coach to come in and change everything.
I'll tell you a coach that has changed something. Because the coach that he need to go. This is a guy we ain't talking about. We don't talk about a lot. Bro, Mike McDaniel, bro, for freaking Tua Tagovailoa, boy. Them boys be cooking. That's the number one offense. Boy, I tell you, look, I'm not going to lie. When Tyreek Hill went to Miami, I was like a little scared for like Tua's confidence in the sense that, you know, this guy just came from Patrick Mahomes and a Chiefs dominant offense. And now you're going to Miami where you're off. You know, I'm like, people going to make fun of him. Like, you're not Patrick Mahomes. You can't do this. Tyreek Hill's going to be trash. Man, Tyreek Hill cooking the league. Boy, I know, look, y'all said that y'all take Devontae over Tyreek. I feel you. I tell you, you come to me, you say, hey, bro, you get Tyreek Devontae. But I get some Tyreek Hill. It's killing the league, but 215 yards. That's the reason why John lost in fantasy is that freaking 38-point performance by Tyreek Hill. Bro, I'm telling you, Tua Tagovailoa, if he don't get no freaking concussions that make his hands do crip signs, if he don't get that and he can play the full season, yo, I'm ready for Tua. I'm ready for that team to finally get that 12-win season. They might F around, win that whole division. It ain't going to be the Jets no more.
It's only two people in there.
It's either the Bills or the Dolphins. And we just said, what, Josh Allen got bottom five IQ? It's time for some Tua.
And they had Jalen Ramsey, but he left. But he got injured. So imagine they had sad Jalen Ramsey on that team.
Well, he coming back, though.
There you go.
Because that offense is fun. They got all the speed in the world. Even their running back, their rookie running back got... but you know plot, right? But no, yeah, I'm hoping to look. Miami's not known, like, they don't have the best plot. Not. But they're not known for, like, just ridiculously bad plot. You see what I'm saying? So they can have a year, and I want Miami to have the year. I want, like, a Chiefs versus Dolphins playoff game. Because I just want to see speed and offense. I just want to see all that. Because Tyreek Hill going and playing against Kansas City and Tua, but that's fire. I thought Tua's career wasn't going to be hitting, honestly. I thought Tua wasn't going to be that guy. But Mike McDaniel, bro, and he one of them chill coaches too. You know what I'm saying? He relate to his players, and it worked. You would think a player coach don't really work like that, but it worked because that man cooking the league. So, hey, is Tua better than Justin Herbert?
Hey, yeah, that's a good point, because at first I was like, man, Tua, he's really not that guy. But now it's flipped to if Tua stays healthy, now they're a Super Bowl team. So, like, that's just crazy how you can flip your image. Because when he went down, everybody, and you know, when they start losing games, they're like, well, if Tua was healthy, they would have won. But at first, it was like, let's go get another QB. Let's go get Deshaun Watson.
Don't get him. bring good plot. You know, that man do not look good. That man do not look good, bro. He came out on top, but that man do not look good at all.
He had a bad
boy.
Game. For
real? Yeah, he didn't play well. But, like, the defense, the thing, boy. But Deshaun Watson, he's rusty, but it's like, you were rusty last year, too. You're going to be rusty this year. Rusty next week. Rusty next year. You're going to be rusty for the rest of your career. it's all about plot. And he in Cleveland, too. So that plot shouldn't generate anything. I did want to ask y'all, though, besides the Cowboys and 49ers, what teams do you think had the most impressive showings
on the Jets.
You dig me?
That's true. They did have very impressive showing. Now, do what they keep that? No.
Just enjoy the season.
I'll probably change this to that next week.
Hey, if you win, definitely do that. But what about y'all? What do y'all think? I'm at the thing, too.
I mean, Lions look good. The defense looked better than I thought it was.
That's because that man Kadarius Toney don't know how to catch balls, but. Took that boy from the New York School of Wide Receivers. Do not know how to catch balls. Mm-hmm. Tough. What about the Rams? I think the Rams. What about the Rams? You said, what'd you say, Maurice?
I said the Cowboys as well. They had a pretty impressive one.
I said, besides the Cowboys and the 49ers. He said the Cowboys, though.
Oh, the 49ers.
Oh, no. That got to be it. That got to be it. I forgot about them boys. Ooh. To me, it's the Green Bay Packers and Jordan Love cooking Chicago like it's Aaron Rodgers all over again, boy. That is home cooking. That's beautiful home cooking. Boy, in Chicago?
I did like the Bucks win.
That was impressive against Minnesota. Yeah.
Again, especially with Baker Mayfield. I did like that. That was a pretty impressive win to me.
That was an upset. I definitely wouldn't have expected.
It wasn't like nothing major, but it was like, okay. Yeah.
But I wanted to see if Jordan Love had, like, because, you know, the tree of there's Brett Favre and Aaron Rodgers. I want to see the tree go another decade to 15 years. And, bro, like, hey, Jordan Love, I'm not saying he doing nothing for 15 years, but I'm saying, though, he is following tradition of cooking the Bears. Because cooking the Bears is very important to these Green Bay folk. Feel me? Because that man, the way he cooked freaking Chicago in Chicago, that man Justin Fields year three ain't looking like he did anything at all. That man, they did not target that man DJ Moore at all. They spent they traded their pick to get some DJ Moore and then get that man the ball. Now, that's hilarious. Cooking the Bears is a part of their diet, and it's hilarious. So, I think Jordan Love, hey, I'm impressed with Jordan Love. I'm definitely going to keep seeing if Jordan Love can continue. Just have a decent season, like 25 touchdowns. 20 to 25 touchdowns, maybe 10, 11 interceptions. I think as long as he cook in Chicago, everything is good. I think definitely, was it 38 to 20, something like that?
Yeah. I don't know. A lot of people, really? they pretty high on Justin Fields. Like, they were even saying that he's better than Jalen Hurts. Just Jalen Hurts has more talent. I'm just like,
that may not, I think that's the opposite. I feel like you should say that. That's, like, I don't
the,
know if it's
the
opposite.
The leader of the Eagles haters club, I'm like, that is crazy to say that. Like, I don't know. I think people take too much credit away from Jalen Hurts. Like, yeah, he has a good team around him, but
he good. No, he a good player. Yeah, so. Justin Fields. I don't know if Justin Fields is a good player.
I haven't seen anything out of him. Like, people been high since Ohio State or whatever school he went to.
Yeah.
I haven't seen anything that made me say, okay, this guy got potential.
He just runs.
Of course.
Yeah, he can just run.
Of course, he doesn't have, like, the talent around him to where we can really judge, but it's like, how can you say that about somebody who's proven, like, somebody who's actually went out and done it? It's crazy to me.
Now, they were hyped. The Bears were very excited for the season because they thought Justin Fields would take that next step because he was second all-time in rushing yards for a quarterback in the season.
Yeah, he didn't deserve to break his record.
Lamar Jackson.
They always fall for it. They should have asked me. They always hype people up. every single time I draft a quarterback, the next year I was like, they'd be like, oh, now it's just 1 year. It's rookie. They're gonna make mistakes. Next year he'll be fine.
I mean, Bree's going through some
Sam Darnold and Zach Wilson. And I knew that shit. Once I saw Sam Darnold was off, I was like, yeah, I ain't gonna fall the same shit with Zach Wilson.
And if you get Caleb Williams and he's like too, then I think you should quit football.
He probably will say, no, actually, let me see. Because I'll tell you this. This is always, if you look into history, I think
okay.
If you look at history, any year the Jets do not draft a quarterback, right? That usually that year is a pretty good year for quarterbacks. The year, except for the only like abnormality is Trevor Lawrence. But it took him a while to come. But as of late, in the year we draft a quarterback.
Is that quarterback class bad though? Like your quarterback, because like, Zach Wilson's all time terrible. Justin Fields is pretty mid. Who's the other quarterback? Is that Mac Jones, the other quarterback in there?
Is he the other quarterback in there? I didn't even know he was in
that. Was he in that quarterback class?
Maybe he's in,
or was he in the one before?
I think he's the one with Justin Fields. I mean, Justin Herbert. So I thought.
Okay. What class is Mac Jones in?
I thought he's the one with Justin Herbert and Tua.
I don't think he's 2019.
Well, because he came in the year after, he left. So yeah, he had to be 2020.
So he's 20. Okay.
Zach Wilson's 20.
So that's Joe Burrow. That's the Joe Burrow class.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Yeah, because he had a decent. Because I know they went him and Tom Brady had a face off.
I just look because Zach Wilson's 21.
Yeah,
because we got Mekhi Becton 2020.
Okay. Who was Trevor? That's another person I'm missing. I feel like in that 21 class.
Was that Hurts?
Wasn't Mac Jones 21?
Was he?
I think maybe he's 20. Maybe he's. I remember Josh Allen.
Because I remember Josh him and Tom Allen Brady, you know. Let me see. I thought they went head to head.
Is somebody looking it up? Yeah,
see if you just go guess forever.
somebody go right.
Mac Jones, Michael McCorkle, 2021 pick 15. We cooking the noggin 2021. He was. I think he played the best out of all of them in that rookie season. That's what I'm thinking. I'm like, someone I'm missing. He played the best out of everybody in that rookie season.
Yeah.
Which is terrible.
The Urban Meyer
freaking effect is pretty strong. But yeah, that man Mac Jones. So that's not that bad of a class, I guess. I mean, but Zach Wilson, boy, that man dragged it down. Boy. And he was supposed to have Patrick Mahomes' arm talent, too.
Trey Lance is in that draw.
Oh, he sucked, too.
Mm-hmm. There you go. Told you.
That class off of boy.
Justin Herbert's was in. I mean, Justin Fields. I mean, I'm not saying these quarterbacks are going to be, like, terrible, terrible, but.
They no. If you Trey look Lance.
Out, tough, what's the boy. Next year?
2022.
Do 2020, right? I drafted Mekhi Becton.
Joe Burrow.
This shit not going to go back, bro. All this fucking.
Look, as long as the 2023 class is good, too, from you not drafting a quarterback, we cooking.
That's all it is. Yeah, so there you go. Exactly. You.
That's what I'm hoping.
There you go.
And with the rookie quarterbacks, I'm going to talk real quick about the rookie quarterbacks. Bryce Young, just do an order. Bryce Young struggled. Versus Atlanta. I don't know if it's Atlanta's a good defense, but he struggled. It's fine though. Bryce Young. They're gonna make memes about Bryce Young because he's small. But it's fine. It's regular for a rookie quarterback to struggle. CJ, he played Baltimore. He had three offensive linemen down, so I expected hell. He had 200 some passing yards, one bad. He didn't look bad. It's just the three offensive linemen going down, and they go down right before the season start too. Like, just dropping like flies. And I'm just like, where'd he go? I got no center. I got no right tackle. Damn. Where my guard at? That's tough. So I expected pain. So hey, I thought it'd be a worse performance, to be honest, because, that's very important. And my man, Anthony Richardson, he had the best performance out of the rookies. Shane Steichen helped Jalen Hurts, become a really good player. So obviously that's a good marriage with Anthony Richardson. He surprised me. I did expect him to be a little more raw. He has that Cam Newton type build where he keeps running and taking hits that he shouldn't take. So he took a hit to his knee, got a bruised knee. So, he keep doing that. That's tough. But I think the only thing that stops the Colts from being like second in the division is themselves, because they have Jonathan Taylor, who was like an elite running back, and they can have a run game that can just transcend everything, but they don't want to pay him because their owner is ridiculously stupid. And that's fine, because it's fine for them to nerf their team for me. I'm not going to win nothing, but obviously I face the Colts next week, and it's going to be a battle between quarterbacks, and everybody going to be on Twitter saying, this guy looked like that.
That's going to be a real good matchup. Because now that's like an even matchup. Now you can really judge the QBs, like, okay, y'all going against, well, never mind. Colts, they got a decent defense, so it's not really.
They got defense, too.
The Texans?
Yeah.
Their defense played well till Jalen Petrie got hit in his chest and started coughing up blood, and then everything fell off. And I was like, that's tough. That's pretty tough, my starting safety coughing up blood. Funny thing is, too. And I told Maurice this, like, I'm only two steps away from Jalen Petrie in the sense of that my girlfriend went to college with Jalen Petrie's girlfriend, and they were friends, but they're not friends no more. And I'm like, why y'all not friends no more? Come on, like, what's wrong with y'all? Like, could you not find a way to get to, like, I'm like two conversations away. I talk to my girl, and then my girl talks to, his girlfriend. Hey, you want to do a double date? I like, sure.
Sold.
Nah, but that's beautiful. I love how that sold me at the, she shouldn't have told me that information too. I definitely could have not known about that. Ignorance is bliss. But hopefully he's well. He coughing up blood, had a bruised lung. Hopefully you're well, bro, because I can't get no, I can't hang out with you if you got coughing up blood and all that. So hopefully you're doing well, bro. And hopefully you play this weekend so we have a chance beating the Colts, because our defense went like this when you left. I know safety's important, but I didn't expect such a strong descent this way. But I think we did a pretty good job against Lamar Jackson. Lamar Jackson was pretty mid on Sunday. So I think we did he gave Maurice like 7 fantasy points or something. I think we did a decent job.
That's also the top 5 quarterbacks, I think. They in the AFC, at least. I don't think they really played well.
Yeah, so we gotta wait till next week. We can't judge Josh Allen so fast, right? You gotta wait till next week, right?
No,
I can definitely.
It's just not one game.
No, but that's an easy judge. Those are like clear, easy mistakes that you could have could have been avoided.
Yeah, they're clear, but that's what we put his IQ down for, because it's something, even though it's like he does that. This is not new for him. Like, that's just who he is. So it's like Westbrook. We like some of his turnovers. We just be like, obviously you shouldn't do that, And going back to his rookie year, Josh Allen's like when he threw the ball back against the Texans. We all chucked it up like, okay, that was a rookie mistake. But now it's like, bro, you an NFL player. Like, that's not – we learned not to do that in, like, middle school. So is it really a rookie mistake? Or is it just
– bottom like 5 IQ, boy. Hey, we'll see next week with the bottom 5 IQ.
Who they play?
Who do they play? I don't know. Let me see. But as I pull that up – for your team next week, or for your team coming in week 2, like, tell me, do you expect, and it's easy, obviously, for the two on the side, but do you expect to win? And if you do expect to win, especially, this is more for Jared as well, because like I said, the one on the side, you could kind of easily say that match is pretty easy. But it's like, do you expect to win next week? And if you do win, why do you win the game? And Jared, you probably should go first. I don't know.
We play the Commanders, I believe. I do expect to win that game because it's the Commanders. I hope it doesn't look bad though. If you lose, if it's an ugly win, if we lose,
that's not bad. Oh my God. It's 13-10 game, and you lose. That's
God. If we can score more than 16 points, I'll be happy.
But y'all had the worst scoring offense in the league last year, something like that. It was close.
Yeah, we averaged 16 points. 16 is like the magic curse number for the Broncos. I mean,
at least y'all met y'all met your quota.
Yeah, we need Javonte Williams to get going.
That too.
Yeah. Man, there's a lot of things.
And y'all missing your number one. It's a lot of things y'all personnel. Missing. Y'all not fully there yet. You're not fully healthy.
Well, if y'all start 0-2 and you score 12 points or 13 points for it, that's going to be a good laugh. I'm sorry. And then I got to get the rest of it. That's funny, boy.
Yeah, have to take what you call it down a little bit.
Sean Payton does 6.
Yeah.
Nah, you take it to 5.
Dang, boy. Roast that man. For me, versus Indianapolis, I don't know. That's such a close matchup. We at home, though. It's in Houston. Okay. But such like, because I can see selling, though. We have good selling in our heart. I feel like we lose this. Like, I want to win this, but I feel like we lose, like, 17-14. Something stupid going to happen to me. I got the vibe of that. I don't know. I'm not confident.
I think y'all win.
You think we win, huh?
But, like, opposite.
I mean, but like, we win 17-14.
Like, yeah.
If they had Jonathan Taylor, it'd be a loss for sure. If we had Jonathan Taylor, they'll be definitely good thing they don't.
I think the Texans win. I picked them in my Pick'em league. I think they'll win.
I don't know who I put. I gotta go look at the Pick'ems as well.
Like I picked Houston, but that's me. Like I was hype in that moment, but I'm like, should I still pick Houston? I mean, they didn't play bad against Baltimore. Well, their offensive line did, but like that was just expected. But like I don't know. Yeah, I'm picking Indy. I'm just be safe for now. I'll just be safe. We'll see.
I'll pick Houston, I think.
Yeah. And y'all, Maurice, what you gotta do beat the Cowboys?
Me?
What you gotta do beat the Cowboys?
Get Tom Brady.
You mean like current Tom Brady or like 2010 Tom Brady?
No, give Aaron Rodgers my Achilles. Is my Achilles better than Aaron Rodgers?
No, it wouldn't be. No, it would pop too, isn't it? Your Achilles will pop on it.
I wonder,
are y'all playing in New York or are you playing in Dallas?
Playing Dallas.
Oh, they got turf too. Yours would pop as well.
Yeah, I got turf? Oh, yeah, but I got the dome though.
They ain't stopped nobody from tearing Achilles. You still can tear your Achilles.
But I'm saying it's not going to be like wet out there. It's going to be at least. All these fucking turf and shit. I don't
know. How many grass stadiums are there?
There's 14.
Green Bay, Bears.
The Bears have, yeah. It's 14.
14?
It's less.
Interesting.
So, yeah, the rest is like, we save money. We got the same artificial turf the Cowboys do.
I thought y'all.
14 out of 30?
Maybe it's a Cardinals. 32.
No.
One of the worst 14 out of
32. Chargers share, Jets share with the Giants.
Oh, look at you.
Yeah.
I forget people do that. I yes. Gotcha. You got me. 14 out of 30.
I was about to say 32. You said it before me, though. Appreciate that.
that's got me with the smartest. But yeah, so Reese, is there anything realistic you could do? Or John, you can also say, is there anything realistic that the Jets can do to win?
Because I don't know why y'all making this game like it's just a layup. It's not like this is not just a layup game. This is gonna be a competitive game. I'll say we're gonna win. Probably. Let's see. It really. Let me give you a good score.
Oh yeah, give me what that
probably cooks. About 20-17.
Yeah, they scored 17 points, but the Jets, the offense, but cooking. Yeah. Someone got hurt. Zach Wilson got hurt.
It really depends. Cause like you know, I mean, Dak, he'll have an interception or two.
Zach will have 4.
Yeah, I can see him definitely having 1 or 2interceptions.
That boy Zach Wilson. Zach Wilson scores
are just like
what's going to stop? The thing is, because we're going to play the same way the Giants.
And another thing is like if you see the opening drive for the Giants, like they were running the ball, like it looked good the first drive.
Yeah, but then it stops.
I mean, y'all gotta. I mean, like I said, that's.
But y'all stop.
I don't know if it was just because you were playing me in fantasy, but that looked like Adrian Peterson to me. So.
But that boy Breece Hall was going up with. That boy Breece Hall was going up.
I mean, you know, averaging 12
yards a carry. Every
time he touches the ball, it's a first down, bro. Like, so if he's coming, like, we'll see. You know, because that's our weakness on defense is the run stop. That's why we drafted Smith to be an inside stuffer.
How's just off the Giants run? How's just off the Giants?
It's just okay, once switch. We block the kick.
Oh, they have to switch.
And then they started having to pass. Okay. It's just like everything started going bad for them. But the first drive, they went all the way down. Like, they were running the ball pretty well. So like, on his first drive, he probably was averaging, like, 5 a carry.
So, the same thing can happen to the Jets?
Yeah. The same thing. I mean, if y'all score first, or, like, if y'all establish the run on, like, the first drive, y'all will be good.
Yeah, y'all start trying to throw it. Y'all know, like, you come into the game knowing that.
But it don't matter if you know something. People know Derrick Henry. It's like we don't have the personnel.
We to know stop that he's gonna
that's
kill
not
me.
Our personnel. Like that, we that, have look, small that was 100%. DTs.
The Texans knew what Michael to do Parsons. With Derrick Henry, but we just couldn't do it.
We have Michael Parsons, another small. We have DeMarcus Lawrence. These are slim guys. They're built for stopping the pass. So
you
that's why like, when people run the ball, it's like you know
you can't give him Maurice because the thing is we try to give Maurice Hope and then he got the worst. Hope. No, but you're trying to get, like, because there's an opening. You're like, there's not going to be a slam dunk. But, like, Maurice is, like, so shut off because he's, like, abused. So he's so shut off.
Yeah, he's not even paying attention, bro.
I'm just here.
Like, all right, whatever you say.
I'm just here so you can get 1,000 subscribers, dog.
that's all I really hope, though. Like, I hope it's not a close game. I hope we come out there and watch y'all. But
I think it could be 40-zip again because Zach Wilson, I think, worse than Daniel Jones.
I think so.
And boy, it's in Dallas, and I know Zach, bro.
Hey, I'm gonna say
defensive travel, but Zach Wilson can't
score. It's a trap game.
I think we're gonna score just because it's not raining. We're gonna be inside. That's the only reason.
It's a trap game. It's really a trap.
See,
game.
If this was Aaron Rodgers, now we cooking. This match would have been fire. I know this is America's game of the week. I know it'd be because I know they wanted this to be the 325 America game of the week, big time game. Aaron Rodgers
like
at Dallas
more than the Monday Night Football game.
For who? For you?
No, like the NFL.
Oh, you talking about that Aaron Rodgers? Yeah.
Aaron Rodgers. Now, see,
they wanted this.
Ain't gonna lie, I would feel more confident in winning if we was facing Aaron Rodgers.
That's so ridiculous.
What?
Let me explain why. Because like the Cowboys, like that's how we play down to competition, bro. Like, I don't know. It just don't make sense what we be doing.
Because
I feel like they're coming with their A game. I feel like, just how y'all saying Zach Wilson, I feel like internally they're going to be thinking that. And they're going to start, even like Josh Allen, you could tell like, well, I guess you can't tell, but I feel like he went down some because it's Zach Wilson.
They gonna
like
put
you
on
can
easy
do
mode,
certain stuff that you wouldn't like, do.
They're going to put on easy
say
mode.
What?
They're going to be they like, oh, hard mode. They're going to be like, it's a
yeah,
chest.
Like you can do certain there. Stuff when you playing people like that. Like
bro, last year,
if,
y'all
when
faced
it's Aaron
Green
Rodgers,
Bay.
Like we'll be conservative. Stuff
y'all faced
like
Green
that,
Bay
like,
last year, and they weren't good. Yeah. Green Bay was not good last year, and that boy and I benched that man, and that man had the best game of his season, and that's freaking stupid boy. So
but it was
I,
trash look, time until you end up winning.
But Aaron, yeah, I'm telling you, look, no real talk. The Jets have too many primetime games right now. They had no.
They,
at one point, it makes sense,
and that's the reason
but
why
Jets,
I knew this should go.
They're gonna get flexed.
No, but look, Jets at Kansas City, bro.
Gone.
But you need to change that quickly, boy. Desert Kansas City, Aaron Rodgers versus Patrick Mahomes is going to be lit.
Can we take them all
Zach
off?
Wilson versus Patrick Mahomes
I think
be
we
trash.
Got Sunday Night Football, too. First time.
Now that's the Sunday Night Football game.
Oh, really?
That's the Sunday.
Yeah.
Jets, Chiefs, look. We already made that mistake. We made that mistake with the Broncos down here last year. Game mm-hmm. too many primetime games put mm-hmm. me to sleep. 13-9 losses all happened. I don't see that no more. Zach Wilson, don't know. He had a whole offseason. Aaron Rodgers supposed to be his mentor. We going you know, he gonna mentor him to be better. That man looked exactly the same. So, you know, and I know, and John, you
one
just say,
game,
look,
bro.
No,
you
but look,
say
I
hate that.
No, but look, I know exactly. It's like, yeah, he didn't
come
expect.
On, come on, John.
He didn't
bro.
Expect.
Like,
he didn't expect.
Why you got so much confidence in this nigga?
I don't have confidence, but I just think that's not a fair assessment.
Like
you
on,
getting
boy.
Thrown into the Lions.
He didn't expect that,
saying,
though.
Produce.
He didn't expect that. That's like, a fair point. He didn't expect that.
You now he's gonna get a week. Well, and don't judge him off this
too.
Week as well, bro.
He gonna have an all time. No, look, he throws seven interceptions, boy. He gonna throw seven interceptions.
Don't judge him off this week either. Who y'all face the following week after us?
They schedule hard, but they ain't got no easy schedule.
Either Patriots or the Eagles, one or two.
They facing he going through hell, boy.
Saying, bro, look at all these games, bro. Like
it's hell week. That man facing all these super teams, boy.
Maybe I don't know.
Look. Come on, bro. Look at these defenses he's going against.
But the thing is, I'm going to be so pissed about Zach Wilson because if I was Zach Wilson, I would have been chilling behind Aaron Rodgers for like a year or two. I can stay in the league two more years. You know what I'm saying? I get an extra two more years of contracts. Nice. You know what I'm saying? Then they give me another chance after the 2 years over, so I'd be in the league for 5-6 years. Boy, he going to stink it up like crazy this year. They send him to the shadow realm. Boy, they send that man straight to the shadow realm.
Y'all face the Giants week three?
Oh, no, we face the Patriots. This would have been a good year to have Aaron Rodgers, too.
I know, but game. That was a good year to have Zach.
No,
that's why I was going to stream a lot with you.
Yeah, we're going to get the Giants this year, too. I didn't know we were going to get the Giants.
I'm telling you, he got
a QB coach now. A Hall of Fame QB coach.
That nigga ain't going to be there.
Aaron Rodgers going to be in his ear, bro. Aaron Rodgers fell in love with the Jets. So Aaron Rodgers is going to do whatever.
And that's tough,
too,
boy. He love him some Jets, too. That's Zach Wilson. But he got no plot.
That's what I'm saying. Like, now, it's like, he can really just let Aaron Rodgers call the plays.
We'll see.
But Aaron Rodgers need to be Sean McVay. You hear me? This changes man, Zach.
But he can
that man,
see, like he can see what's going on. Aaron Rodgers, he gotta probably be the smartest.
The thing I don't want Zach Wilson to do, right, is like force the ball. And he's the king of forcing the ball.
He will. Try to fit that bad boy.
And that is the reason why. And that's the reason why. You had a lot of confidence in the game. But
Zach Wilson is the worst quarterback I have ever seen.
But I think
he tried to make a play where there's no play to be happy. He just throw the ball away. He do that shit.
That can be coached out of you, though.
I mean, year three, I need to see something
exactly.
happen, bro.
I mean, year three.
Coach out of you. Know what I'm saying? Especially.
I think Sam Darnold had 3 years.
You know the best way to coach
it
out of you is to have Adrian Peterson.
I don't understand how this man
had 12 yards of carry. It just don't make sense.
Brees Hall was killing it last year,
yeah,
and he tore his ACL.
Yeah,
he tore his ACL.
We would have made the playoffs if we had had
I thought he was the guy who got shot. I don't know
Brian
why
Robinson.
I was
Oh, that's Brian Robinson.
Yeah, I don't know why I was thinking that. I'm tripping.
I'm trying to figure out who else going to be injured on the Jets to like hurt their season more because it's plot.
No, because I know I was thinking that same exact shit, too, but it's going to be late. You know what it's going to be? Knock on wood. It's going to be Sauce Gardner. It's probably going to be Sauce Gardner or some shit. Right?
Mm-hmm. Nah.
He going like, I don't know, something going to happen with his ankle or some shit. But it's going to be later in the season.
Achilles?
I don't know if it's Achilles, but it's going to be later in the season, right? Just so when Aaron Rodgers come back, it'll be like, oh, damn, Sauce Gardner can't start the season. He also can't start. That's why I know it's going to be later in the season.
Oh, yeah, and fold that and give it to you. It'll be week 16. That man, he's going to have a torn Achilles, 10 to 20 ACL. He's going to start week 6, week 7 next year. So your pass defense next year is going to be struggling to begin because you got Sauce Gardner. Cook. Right.
If nobody get injured, that makes it worse because it's like you had a complete healthy team besides your QB. All you needed was one piece.
Oh, we can write that down. So, like, you know, they play really
like
well, but they miss. But then next year, Aaron Rodgers come back. He's like, when Aaron Rodgers come back, he'll be good. But he not going to be good because he got torn Achilles and he's trying to recover. He's 40 years old, and he's going to be terrible. So we're going to collect that. That's going to be like the mystery because that's definitely what the Jets got, like the mystery type. Like, man, we would have won the Super Bowl if we had Aaron Rodgers.
Nah, it's going to be like, it's probably going to be like a waste of 2 years because I think obviously not going this year. And then next year, we're going to – like, to me, you said Super Bowl was – I guess everybody's aspiration for this year. I don't think we would make the Super Bowl. I think we made the playoffs, maybe lost in the second round. I was thinking like the next year or some shit after will probably be the Super Bowl because we have like more time with that. But now we pushing back a whole year. We just got pushed back a whole year. So that means next year is going to be Super Bowl aspiration. And I feel like we're going to fail that shit miserably. But
imagine you write the script and you say, first snap, second, third snap of the season, Aaron Rodgers has a torn Achilles tendon. Like, who wrote that down, bro? Like, why they give you that plot, bro? Like, they couldn't let you have nice things.
I don't know.
I mean, I was walking around one day. I said, bro, the Jets have Aaron freaking Rodgers. Like, I looked at Aaron Rodgers play for years, and he just does everything right as a quarterback. I'm like, that is the guy.
Did you say something about the Achilles, like you did with Sam Darnold, and he got mono?
That's hilarious. Like, that's hilarious. Like, I ain't jinx you like that. But it's funny, like, you get Aaron Rodgers, he run out with that flag. That's his highlights.
That was a good ass camera shot, too.
And look, that was
I even
great.
Said that
was
shit before. I never seen MetLife like that before. At nighttime, I never seen that shit.
They were ready to jump. This was it. You know, and that's his highlight. And that was a good highlight.
That was.
Unfortunately, he had the worst low light he could possibly have.
And then after that, it went back to, like, normal, just what it's supposed to be.
Boy, we gotta get your plot up. But you got, but you did say that you got the Joe Namath curse, and then you saw Joe Namath right before the game or whatever.
Yeah, I did see Joe Namath right before the game. So,
but I'm not gonna. We not wishing no harm on no Joe Namath. You know what I'm saying? You just gonna have to live with that curse as long as possible.
It'll be 150,
and you gonna be dead, and never he gonna outlive you, and you would never see no Jets happiness. That's. The thing is, he sold his soul. That's what they said. He sold his soul to win the Super Bowl because he wasn't supposed to win it. And they ain't went 50, 60, almost 60 years since. So,
yeah.
Hey, plot's tough, boy. And you have the worst. No, you don't. The Cleveland do, but they got Deshaun Watson. That shouldn't help them. So, yeah, week two going to be fun. I'm definitely going to be here on streaming, doing my streaming thing. Another segment probably could do next week if y'all want to is I just want to do a prediction of like the who going to win the awards. We can do that next week. In our next podcast. But hey, thank you guys for tuning into this podcast. Hey, shout out to Denver and them losing the exact same way. Shout out to Maurice for ending his season before it started. Shout out to John. The Super Bowl aspirations, maybe not for him, but for his fan base, gonna be high because they blanked out somebody.
Super Bowl aspirations for the Giants. See, he's so high on them.
But he's very high on the Giants too. Hey, the whole NFC East making the whole thing, man. The whole NFC East making the playoffs, and they all gonna be battling each other in the divisional round against each other. And
it depends if they beat the Broncos. Then you know, if they beat the Broncos, then I have some faith in Washington. But if they lose,
and if the Broncos lose, that's hilarious because that means none changed. We back to year two, so it looked like everybody, the only person who ever traded for a quarterback and got something back great, it was Matthew Stafford and the Rams. Congratulations to you guys, because the Jets, Tom the Broncos,
Brady,
back
Tom
to back.
Tom Brady just signed there?
No, he just signed there. It wasn't a trade. But for the Jets and the Broncos so far, so bad. Tough. And me, I have a highly anticipated matchup, rookie versus rookie. And whoever plays bad, they're going to overanalyze and judge him miserably. So hopefully, my rookie, at least, if he lose, at least play good, because they gonna overanalyze everything, and it's the second game, but they're gonna do that. So I'm we'll see how that goes, and yeah, we're gonna have more streams for you guys, podcasts, et cetera, et cetera. So thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe. It's a road to 1,000. Do it for Maurice. He's going through hell, and I have to hit 1,000 for the end of the season because I have to capitalize off of his loss. We will catch you next video, and we are out of here. Peace.